I just love this tank. With the boat chas. Now the tiger barbs. There we got Lelikert. Growing like weed. But that's not what this video is gonna be about. Because today we are gonna do an update on the Heloderma. As some of you might know, I got two Heloderma horridum about a year back now from a friend, and yeah, absolutely great animals, but they are actually leaving. They will be leaving tomorrow, so I thought to myself, well, I have not nearly shown these enough, so let's take a last look at them before they are, yeah, gonna leave. So that's what we're gonna do today. I'm actually gonna feed them a bit of egg. Now this is the like third time I ever fed them egg, but I'm out of rodents. So then I thought to myself, well, why not give them a treat before they are gone? So let's see how they are going to react to the egg. You can see it can already smell the egg. It is curiously using that tongue. Now I'm gonna try not to have it eat the egg in the tub, but next to it. So we can take a nice look at the animal, and also to prevent the substrate getting all sticky and it eating the substrate. Why aren't you focusing? There you go. So let's see if we move this. Move it and see if it finds the egg. Well, that went easy. Anyway, I think these are absolutely amazing animals. So they are not leaving because I did not like them. It's simply because I want to get back to two rooms and these need a lot of space. And as you can see, they are still in a tub. And I gotta say, I absolutely hate the fact that I'm still keeping them in these tubs. So they definitely needed an upgrade way sooner. You know, they have grown so much, as you can see. Just look at how big they are now. And not only is it not cool for the animal, but I deprived myself and the animal of a lot of stimulus, I would almost say. And what I mean with that is I did not give myself the best opportunity to actually enjoy these incredible animals for what they are. Keeping them in the tub, not only are you depriving yourself of a lot of behavior you can see and a lot of interaction, you know, you gotta open it up and stretch out the animal before you see it. Now I know a lot of people say these animals don't do a lot, but that's actually not true. I saw them moving along the top a lot. And yeah, so that's kind of a bummer, you know. That's also why I didn't take you along a lot. I just don't really like to show that stuff because I want to show people the other side of the hobby and not just collecting animals in tubs. So they can be useful. I will still use them for a fovis, but having these animals in the tubs like I did, definitely I deprived myself of the amount of enjoyment I could have, because I feel these are just great animals that you should keep in a nice setup. Horridum horridum, the beaded lizard, will also climb a bit more as Gila's. I experienced them to be a bit more active as Gila monsters. So yeah, keeping them in the tub the way that I did, it functions, but that's about it. So to sum all that up, horridum horridum, they're not leaving because they are not great animals, because I think they're absolutely fantastic. They're simply leaving because I was not able to enjoy them to the fullest, keeping them in this manner. So when I needed to make a choice which animals I was gonna keep going back to two rooms, unfortunately these just didn't make it. Now, while this one is wrapping up its egg, let's talk a bit about these incredible lizards. As mentioned, these are Heloderma horridum horridum. You also have the Heloderma horridum exasperatum. Then there is the Heloderma horridum alvarezi and the Heloderma horridum Charles Bogarty. And this is I will probably butcher the name, but the Oaka locality. Now, I know Gila monsters are a bit more popular because they often have more color, but I like the body shape of the beaded lizards way more. They are a bit more slender, a bit longer. As you can see, they have way longer paws in comparison to the Gila monsters because they actually climb a lot more. These are also often not found in more desert areas, but more of a dry forest area. As you can see, it's actually pretty curious. So that's stuff I did miss, you know? Anyway, they also have a longer tail, as you can see over there. So yeah, I think that looks way cooler. I think a Gila monster is pretty much like a big skink with some venom glands. These are just way cooler. They also get a lot bigger. Some specimens can get like almost a meter long. Now, as you can see, they have those big bulges on their lower jaw, and that is where the venom glands are. So a lot of venomous snakes have their venom glands over here on the back of their head, but the Heloderma horridum and the Gilas have them actually over there. And I gotta watch my finger, because although it's reacting kind of cool, you never know, and I must not forget that these are indeed venomous lizards. And although it probably won't kill you, it will hurt, that's for sure. So yeah, raising these animals in a tub like I did is not too bad of an idea. I think that will work great. They did great over here, especially when they're young. They're a bit more shy or also a lot more defensive. I do not handle these lizards at all, only if I'm taking them out to clean the substrate or whatever, but in general I just leave them be. And they have calmed down so much compared to when they first got here. So yeah, it's very interesting. Anyway, keeping them in tubs like that is possible when they're young, but I do think when they gain a bit more confident and they become more active, because they are also active during the day, especially when they're a bit hungry, they will look for food. So yeah, keeping them in terrarium then is way more logical, because then they can dig more, they can climb, you can actually see them behave. And that's what's so fun about this hobby, you know, not only having the animal but actually enjoying them for what they are and observing their behavior, like this stuff. So yeah, that's absolutely something I would recommend. In comparison, they are not as active as some agamids or phoranids, but still they will use that space. I have seen people keeping these in groups. They are apparently easier to keep in groups than, for instance, Gila monsters. Gila monsters are way more territorial, but still I chose to keep them separate just to prevent any problems. They are pretty careful when it comes to feeding, but if they're hungry, they will run towards their food, jump up a bit, so that's kind of fun. But in general, when I fed them and I presented to them, they just grabbed it. Of course, they are also used to eating their prey, and that's what they also would do in nature. They're not very active hunters. They do not have the body shape to chase after their prey, so they would look for more defenseless animals that they can feed on. They're definitely opportunists. They will raise nests with eggs or young animals without a problem. They do not need to feed too much. I think this body type, it's perfect for the species. Not too chunky, not skinny, but also not too full, just a bit elongated. So this is the way you want to go. You can feed them a lot. They love baby rats, mouse, chicken or chicken pieces, beef heart, and as you can see, egg. But I do not feed egg that much actually. So this is a nice treat before they are taking the trip back home, I should say. Okay, let's have this one finish and then take a look at the other one. Okay, this one directly walks out of the tub looking for food. It's a bit more defensive. But that's okay, I will let it walk around. Doesn't make up for, you know, when they did not have the chance. But at least, I hope this is some stimulation for it. This one is absolutely incredible. I like those very dark, dark animals. Bright spots. The parents of these were also amazing. What you doing? Don't try this at home. What you doing? That's a nice idea, having a beetle lizard walking around in your crotch area. I'm gonna go underneath. But yeah, imagine having a setup and just having them walk in or out once in a while in the reptile room, exploring their surroundings. That will be so cool. Don't you want egg? Look how pretty this one is. I've actually never done this with them. That's one of the reasons I also want to downsize. Or at least go back to two rooms. Because that way, look, there's egg here. That way you have a bit more limited space, therefore often a bit more limited amount of animals, and therefore you can actually spend a bit more time with them. And don't get me wrong, I would love to keep a lot of animals, but there's only so much time I have. I now have the website I'm fully responsible for, and to make sure I still upkeep the level of care that I think these animals need. Yeah, well, we already talked about that. What's the conclusion? This is why I like a reptile room with a relatively empty floor space, so they can just walk around without me being too. Look, egg for you. Too able to get in between stuff, hurt themselves, or get stuck, or me losing them. So some people asked if I could do a care sheet on these, and I will make one for the website. I think this is going to be a lot of fun, and again, I think these are incredible animals to keep, so if you are interested in them, definitely check out more info about them if you're ready to keep venomous lizards like these. I do know they're not super active again, but with making this video, I did want to bring out the message that I'm actually kind of bummed out by myself. I almost feel guilty for keeping these animals in tubs for such a long time. I'm not dissing on anybody keeping them in tubs, you know, big breeder tubs or whatever. That's your choice. I just want to say that I think if you fully want to appreciate these incredible lizards, because they are amazing, then when they are a bit older, when they are a bit grown and feel more confident, giving them at least a bit more space and opportunities to climb over stuff or dig will not only benefit the animal, but yeah, also just your enjoyment. So I hope that if you take something out of this video, that's it. And if you do not, at least you have seen some very nice beetle lizards eating egg, which is also very satisfying.